Hello guys, for today's video, ang topic natin ay about paano kumuha ng PSA birth certificate online application at paano pa-deliver ng door-to-door. Just type this URL, https://psahelpline.ph/. Guys, nandito na tayo sa PSAHelpline.ph website. PSA Birth Certificate Online Application and Delivery. So, dito na website guys, you can request PSA Birth, Marriage, Death Certificate or Senomar online through PSAHelpline.ph. And nagdi-deliver din sila door-to-door delivery anywhere in the Philippines. Nila dito guys, it's your fast and convenient way of getting your PSA certificate within days. Totoo guys, mabilis sila dito mag deliver ng birth certificate o anumang request mo. Sa payment naman guys, madali lang din, pwede ka sa sa GCash or 7-Eleven. Sabi dito guys, with just a few clicks, you will enjoy the convenience of an online PSA application and receive your PSA certificate at the comfort and safety of your home. Sabi pa dito guys, the ordering process is easy and can be done using a desktop computer or mobile device. The PSA certificates are handed to the rightful owner or authorized requester and only upon the presentation of a valid identification. Reminder guys, so sabi dito, you must be of legal age to make a PSA online application request. Please read the user agreement section for more details. So, pindutin mo lang po yung user agreement na naka-underline ng blue. Meron sa baba guys na sulat, nationwide delivery of PSA certificates. 3 to 4 working days within Metro Manila at 3 to 8 working days naman outside Metro Manila. So, ito yung PSA Helpline User Agreement. So, pakibasa nyo na lang guys sa mga nilalaman po nito. Let's start. Pindutin natin ang Order Now button. Choose certificate type. So, this topic guys, kukunin natin ay birth. So, pipindutin natin ang birth button. Tapos, i-tick natin yung box na I accept the terms and condition and privacy policy. Tingnan muna natin guys. Pakibasa nyo na lang po kung ano yung nakalagay. Tapos balik tayo. Sa privacy policy naman tayo. Ayan guys. Yan yung mga nakalagay dyan. After mabasa, pindutin natin yung dalawang box. Tapos yung isa naman, I consent to the processing of my personal data in accordance with the Data Privacy Act of 2012. After natin mapindot yung dalawang maliit na box, sunod na natin gagawin ay pipindutin natin yung continue button. May tanong siya guys, are you requesting for your own certificate of live birth or for someone else? So, tinatanong niya sa akin guys, kung yung kukunin ko na certificate of live birth ay para sa akin o para sa iba. So, click natin my own birth certificate. So, bago natin pipindutin yung continue button, tingnan muna natin kung sino yung for someone else. So, nakalagay dito, for my son, my daughter, my father, and my mother. May note dito sa baba, if you need a birth certificate for your spouse, please ask him or her to request for the certificate directly. So, balik na tayo sa my own birth certificate. Click natin continue button. So, ayun guys, dito sa request for your own birth certificate, merong 9 steps. To get a copy of your own birth certificate, we will need the following information. So, una, your name, sex, birthday, and valid government issued ID. So, pangalawa, your name as it appears on your birth certificate. So, pangatlo, your father's name. Pangapat, your mother's name. Panglima, your birthplace. Panganim, late registration if applicable. Pampito, the purpose of your request. Pangwalo, legal proceedings if applicable. Pangsyam, your delivery address and contact information. After natin mahanda yung mga kailanganin natin na information, click natin ang continue button. Step 1. Encode your name, sex, birthday, and valid government issued ID. So, ito yung pipil up natin. Pindutin lang natin yung female. Tapos, lagay natin yung first name, then middle name, last name, at saka yung birthday. Select ID type. So, sabi dito guys, you must present the selected ID upon delivery. Our courier will not release the PSA certificate to anyone else. Ito yung mga pagpipilian ng mga IDs. Sundin natin ang Philippine Identification System Digital ID. Ito lang ang meron ako na ID. After natin mapindot, click natin ang continue button. Step 2 na tayo. Click your name as it appears on birth certificate. Dito guys, please make sure your name is spelled correctly as it appears on your certificate of live birth. If you're married, please make sure that the name that appears is your maiden name. So after natin makorek guys, click natin ang continue button. Step 3 na tayo, your father's name. Sabi dito, please mark the checkbox if there is no father in your birth certificate. So, iti-check lang natin yung box na to guys na maliit. So, kung meron naman, lagay mo yung first name, middle name, then last name. So, ayan, tapos na natin nalagyan yung mga information ng your father's name. So, after, click natin ang continue button. So, step 4 na tayo guys. Your mother's name. Dito guys, please use the maiden name of your mother as it appears in your birth certificate. So, ayan guys, nalagyan na natin ng first name, middle name, and last name ng mother. After, click natin ang continue button. Step 5 na tayo guys. Your birthplace. Sabi dito, use the place where you were born. The delivery address for your birth certificate will be collected in step 9. Step 6 na tayo, guys. Late registration. So sabi dito, guys, if your birth certificate was registered late, we will ask for the registration date. Then you can proceed if you are unsure, but it may delay the processing of your order. Sabi pa dito, guys, the certificate you are requesting for may not be digitized yet by the PSA if it was registered late. If there is a chance but you will receive a certificate of negative intact if you continue. So, may tanong, guys, was the certificate registered late? So, ang pipindutin natin, guys, ay no, it was registered on time. So, step 7 na tayo, guys. The purpose of your request. So, merong 6 dito, guys, na pagpipilian. Una, passport or travel, school requirement, local employment, foreign employment, marriage, claims or benefits or loans, late registration, or others. At ang purpose of request natin ay passport or travel. Then, dito sa baba, maglalagay ka ng kung anong country. So, lagyan natin ng Saudi Arabia. So, ayan, nalagyan na natin ang country. After, pindutin natin ang continue button. So, next, step 8 na tayo, guys. Legal or administrative proceedings, if applicable. So, under po ng legal or administrative proceedings, ang sabi po dito, if there were any legal proceedings previously done, we need to know in order to ensure that the copy you receive contains the remarks or annotation. So, kung wala naman, guys, pindutin lang natin yung none. Then, click natin ang continue button. Step 9. Your delivery address and contact information. So, may dalawang delivery option. Una, nationwide door-to-door. Your PSA certificate will be delivered straight to your delivery address. At pangalawa, pick up. You can get your PSA certificate at select pick-up location in Metro Manila. May tatlong reminders. Sabi dito, use an address where you will be available to personally receive your birth certificate. You will keep you updated via email and SMS about the status of your order. Then, this is not your place of birth. So, i-fill up natin yung sa recipient, yung pangalan, tapos house number and street name, the subdivision or building name, then delivery province, then delivery municipality, delivery barangay, then delivery zip code, then mobile number, last ang email address. Ayan, guys, na-fill out na natin yung mga required information. Let's click natin ang continue button. After natin mapindot yung continue, ito na yung kalalabasan niya, guys. Ito na yung certificate of live birth. Check mo lang yung information kung tama. Makikita din sa baba yung delivery address. So, ayan, guys, makikita mo din dyan yung copies, which is isa lang yung nilagay natin. Tapos amount due, 365 pesos per copies po yan, guys. So, may reminder, PSAHelpline.ph. Avoid transacting with online scammers. PSA Helpline does not coordinate transactions and payments through FB Messenger. No additional fees will be charged aside from what is indicated on your order. PSA Helpline accepts orders and payments only through our website and hotline at 8737-1111. Then, i-click natin ang I confirm na maliit na box. Then, click continue. So, meron na tayong reference number ng in-order natin na birth certificate. Ito yung mga online payment option. Pwede sa credit card, pwede sa GCash, pwede sa Paymaya, ShopPay, Bayad Online, 7-Eleven, Bayad Center, at saka Palawan Pawn Shop. Pinili ko dito guys sa GCash kasi madali lang din siya. So ayun guys, doon natatapos ang ating topic for today's video. Ganun lang kadali guys, kumuha ng PSA birth certificate online. Maraming salamat sa inyong panonood.